Beloved, we welcome you to Wednesday's edition of the Voice of Resurrection Devotional. The Lord our God is good. His mercy endureth forever. God is speaking to us, giving us a now word for any one of us going through difficulties. You are facing afflictions, and I'm bringing it in the prayers that avail it much, because the affliction is your prayer project. And when I finish it, then I'll give you examples of people that prayed through, and then we'll go into strategies to overcome. One of the things the Holy Spirit just quickened to me is the noise that Satan makes through affliction. And one of the definitions hidden into the whole Hebrew thing, it says grief, harm, heavy, hurt, you know, things that wound. Watch this. Mischief, misery, noisome. That's what I want to focus on. He's making so much noise. He's intimidating. Remember, the Bible says in the book of 1 Peter 5 that he walketh about as a roaring lion. He's not a lion, but he makes so much noise, you think he's one. That's part of the affliction I want to focus on. They want to talk you out of the power of your own prayer. They want to convince you that what you're praying will not work because maybe you have done this or done that or failed here or failed there, and they're trying to suck the life out of your confidence in your own prayer. But God says, let him pray. Is any afflicted among you? Let him pray. You cannot allow that to happen. No, even if all you can say is, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord, I worship you. Lord, I praise you. Start praying that. Stay there until the Holy Spirit begins to fund that or funnel life to your tepid worship, and it comes alive and becomes vibrant. What are you doing? Drowning out the lying voice of the enemy. Drowning out the noise, the confusion, the lying prophecies, the misery. You know, they know how to go and inflict a wound to a wound, to really irritate that scab and cause a distress or grief or hurt. You see, there's so many avenues that the enemy uses. I said that God will allow afflictions in our lives as a pathway to get to know him. Because as we process these things, then we know the Lord at a deeper level. Some people don't believe that. They believe that everything God will teach you is by the word and then by the Holy Spirit. But the Bible says if we suffer with him, we shall reign with him. You see, I believe that's what the Bible says, but there's another one I'm trying to remember. But suffering is part of our call. It's part of the life of faith, this life. The Bible says, for all they that shall live godly in Christ Jesus shall suffer persecution. So if you're going to live godly in this life, in this present life, you will suffer something. I believe it's not full gospel to teach that. That's very parochial. Yes, there are so many things that are happening to us due to ignorance, due to the lack of knowledge of the Word of God. Yes, but even if we are masters of the Scriptures, there are still things that God allows us to go through that, you know, there's no way to get around. The Bible actually says that we are called to these things. We are called to affliction in the book of 1 Thessalonians, even though I'm getting ahead of myself to talk about that. But let me see if it's in these notes. Not really, but let me find it right quick and read it to you so that will help you understand, so that when the enemy is making noise, let him know that the Lord your God knows where you are and what you're going through, because this is part of the plan of your development in your walk of faith, and in your walk with the Lord. Because in this day that where everybody's preaching cake and ice cream, it's so difficult to hear sound doctrine And then we think, oh, there's no faith in that. Oh, I don't want to hear that. I don't believe in that. But it doesn't really matter what we choose to believe. We should know what the scripture has spoken. And he says, 1 Thessalonians 3, he says, wherefore, when we could no longer forbear, we thought it good to be left at Athens alone, and sent Timotheus, our brother and minister of God, and our fellow laborer in the gospel of Christ, to establish you and to comfort you concerning your faith, that no man should be moved by these afflictions. For yourselves know that we are appointed thereunto. He said, we are appointed to these things. So it's not just because you have sinned or not sinned. That's a different type of affliction. But that's just some things that just pop out of nowhere. You wake up one day, you feel a pain, and they say, hey, you have a mass on your liver. You have this that happened. Now you really have to pray. You really have to face these things. You know, the Jews saw a child that was born blind from birth. They said, well, who sinned? His father or, you know, his mom or who sinned? Jesus says it's not an issue of who sinned. This is a setup for the glory of God to be made manifest in his life. That was an affliction that fell on that family, and they were able to pray through it. And as they continued to pray, they heard about Jesus and they went to him for redress. So that tells me, even if I'm not born with something, I should not accept it. I should pray through it. I should continue to pray and seek God on it until it resolves. But there are things that has been chosen for our spiritual development. Paul writes, we are appointed to these things. 2 Corinthians chapter 6 says that we have to qualify ourselves as ministers of God through affliction. You see? And I love the word that Thessalonians used. He said, we are appointed to it. And I love the third definition, which is the best. He says, we are provided with what is necessary, equipped, furnished, a beautifully appointed office. Now, I love that one. I read it again. We are provided with what is necessary. We are appointed to it, but we are given all that's necessary to go through it. It doesn't say we will not feel the punch or the pain or the pounding, but we've been given all we need. We are equipped. We are furnished. A beautifully appointed office. Hallelujah. The second definition says it's a predetermined, arranged set. You see, these things were set before time, and we have to run through it. Thank God I continue to pray and didn't kill myself or allow the devil, the noise of the devil, to talk me into giving up on my destiny. God loves you, and I'm encouraging you today. Come on, go to church, hear the word of God, get out of depression. You can pray through it in Jesus' name. Amen and amen. See you tomorrow. Bye-bye.